Okay, good evening, PTR. Let me see, we on time or we on 2 minutes late? So I was trying to switch over to my headset here, guys, make this a little bit more comfortable. It was a great day, and I think we have a little bit more information. Gary, you got any information?
We're still trying to confirm, but there's some interesting things happening. As you said, we're trying to confirm with more than one location right now, but things are happening on at the bank level, and everybody's anticipating something tonight. So, and I'm not saying the RV, but they're anticipating the signs of the progress of it going through. Some things are going on the boards. Tony called me and asked me if I could confirm some of the things, and we're starting to look, and the banks are starting to be encouraged because of what they're seeing. And I know, Tony, you said you actually were able to see some of the evidence yourself.
Oh, so you put me on the spot.
Oh, well, I didn't see it. I haven't seen it yet. So, I mean, I can't speak firsthand. I'm speaking third hand here. I love going to the eyewitness, though.
Well, guys, I actually have been sent some things, documents, shots. I've been talking to a whole lot of people. Things are moving on. We're seeing some changes, and I think we're going to have a great weekend. Nothing you can walk in the bank and see right at this moment doesn't mean it won't happen tomorrow, day after, or Monday. I think it is. We've been told that some things are happening in New York, in Washington, across the country. The system is, in fact, upgrading, but we'll wait and see. Now, I can say... I'm trying to think. I actually just left the bank, but I wish I would have left the currency exchange place, but so I could see for myself what's going on. Excuse me. But I think it's all good. I think we got a bunch of people excited. There's a lot of phone calls going back and forth, and I think it's going to be a great, great weekend once again. I say once again because I thought it last weekend because some things happened, some positions were moved. Well, we're back to, I'm trying to think how to say something without saying something. We're back to more money in the banks this weekend. We're back to heightened security. Let me just say that. We're back to banks telling people they may be doing overtime. All those things that we wanted to hear when we were right at the point. So we're right at the point. That's probably all I should say. Until we get some more evidence. But it's a good day. All right, so I guess that's the update. And with that, let's just go right to the questions, I guess. Unless one of the mods had something they wanted to say to update us, or Gary?
Before we go any further, why don't we throw out the phrase for our email so I can be throwing that out there. If you remember, we want to give away, you know, 14 packets today if we can, 10 packets if we can move real quick. I mean, we'll do the 14. That was our charge from Dan before he got on the plane, so let's see if we can make it happen. So why don't we do this? The email, of course, is to 5for10@peoplestalkradio.com. In the subject line, why don't you put in there, it's real. I know a lot of people are wondering what's going on, but basically what we're trying to say is things are progressing. As Dan would say, there's nothing negative, but there's positives. And so it's kind of exciting to watch that happen right now. And I think that as we watch this progress, we can't say that it's going to be tomorrow or, you know, the next day or, you know, but we can say that we're very close. We're right in the season here. So, Tony, you want to take a couple questions while I try to get all these emails popped out?
Okay. All right. Well, let me tell you guys a little bit more since we got a little bit of time, I guess. This is what I've been doing all day. I've been getting phone calls from people. We've been on conferences. They've been telling me what they're hearing from different agencies again today. And, I mean, all the normal players, Washington, you know, the three-letter guys, the Pentagon. I have not heard from over Iraq today. I don't think. I can't remember that part over there to see exactly what they're doing. I'm going to say this one thing. What is going around that's kind of big today was a three-letter agency made the decision for this thing to happen and said it's going to happen, and that's where we're at. And it was the final straw is what we're being told. So without seeing too much, I think. But I'm encouraged. I have been sent some shots from different levels in the banking system. I have been able to talk to some people from different levels in the banking system. And everything really looks good. So I want to tell you guys something else, but I don't know if I can tell you. But it's always like that. So let me say something really, really great might happen. And I personally, this is just my personal opinion, so you guys know, would like to see an RI before an RV, because I think there's a better chance of some of you guys getting richer than rich if that happens. Richer than rich. And only, well, let me tell you guys this. You heard it right here. If it comes out as an RI, that's $3 and something, or as an RI. If it does, just don't forget who moved my cheese. Don't forget about the first mouse. And that's all I'm going to say. And I just said a whole mouthful. Okay. All right. So, Gary, nobody's in the queue yet, right?
Well, here's talking. What I'm going to tell everybody. When you do get the email, check it. You'll see a phone number with a PIN. Dial in, use the PIN, and then hit *6 and 1. It'll put you in the queue. I'm going to turn the queue on right now. And while we're doing that, you can take some questions from our mods.
Hey, Tony, I got a question. I'll go ahead and start this one off. You kind of alluded to, like, the first rat. So are you saying that it will come out higher? I don't want to be caught in that trap. Will it come out higher as an RV after the RI? In your opinion, I know it's just your opinion. You made that quite clear, and I want everybody else to hear that he said it. It was his opinion. We want your opinion on that part. Wait for
my
the second part of it.
Is, without saying anything that I know, my opinion is yes, if it comes out as an RI, it will RV.
At a higher rate is my point, or my question.
Oh, it will have to be a higher rate.
Okay. Because everybody else would ask you the same thing.
Well, just remember this, guys. This is something it should be easy for everybody to remember. Christine Lagarde already said they were going to have a strong currency, right? They've already come out and it's been announced that they're going to have the highest currency in the region. They've already come out and said they're going to have the highest currency in the region. I mean, just think about that. They've made public announcements, so they're going to do one of two things. They're going to make it happen, or they're going to look like dummies without putting the last part to it. You know, dumb those guys. And I don't think they're going to do that. So nobody should have to tell you after that. When you see the number, you should automatically know. But then it's only thing that's going to be left is, you know, do you have the courage to stick it out or not? Or do you take the money and run? I shouldn't say courage. It's just a decision. Because for a lot of people, that's going to be a whole lot of money. So I think it's good. And
Tony,
I said I'm only
here, Mom.
All
I have a
in.
Question when you're done.
If it comes out at a large number, I'm all in. And $3.50 is not a large number to me. But okay, go ahead.
Somebody asked, are we going to be able to get on Facebook IPO? Because what I read is that Facebook is going to IPO possibly Wednesday.
Wednesday? I doubt it. Well, no, I shouldn't say that. Well, it's not the way I had planned on doing it. You could go in there, and if you're in early enough, if you have a broker, then you're probably going to still make a very good profit. I was actually trying to get in before it came out, because that's the secret to IPOs, getting in before they go public. I mean, that's where you're 99.9% of the time guaranteed a return, or at least 90% of the time. And if you're doing ones like Twitter and Facebook and big ones, not just the little companies, then 99% of the time you're guaranteed a really, really great return. So, no, I think you guys are still going to be figuring out what you're doing, how you're doing it, whose name you're putting it in, still moving some money around come Wednesday. So, but Twitter's out there. There are going to be a lot of other ones that you'll be able to take advantage of too. So.
Thank you.
Okay.
Hey, Tony, there was some information out on the boards today regarding Greece and making an announcement in regards to their economic stuff. Do you guys know anything about that? If so, is it something that you can comment or discuss in regards to what that was about?
No, I can't, because I don't know. Right around, I don't know what the article was. So. And if they do make something regarding Greece, when were they supposed to make the announcement?
It said they were going to be making an announcement within hours, but I don't have the article in front of me. I'm driving.
Well, it fits with some other things that you've been hoping for, so we'll see.
Hey, Tony, and while Gary is sending out the rest of those emails, do you want to go ahead and get started on some of the Q&A? We got a person from Florida sitting here waiting.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Let's
okay.
Give away
code 772. Money. And Gary, you take over after that, okay?
Yep, got it.
Wow, I get to be first today. This is Amethyst. How are you, Tony?
I am super fantastic. How are you?
I'm doing just as good.
Okay.
You know, I heard also, and that was part of my question, I heard about maybe 2 hours ago on CNBC that there had been a resolution to Greece, and I was wondering if that might, you know, of course, be some of the movement in this. And then my second question was regarding if this comes out as an RI and then goes to an RV, is it still going to only be able to move up or down? Is it going to be a managed float, or is it going to be able to move that 2%, or is it going to be able to still free float?
Okay, guys, you got to remember the 2% is restricted to what Iraq can do with their own currency, like us changing the value of the dinar or the dollar. It doesn't restrict what Forex does with the currency, what the market does with the currency. It's going to do what it does, okay? Currency is going to be just like any stock or anything else. If it went down too far, they'd take it off the board before they would let it crash. Other than that, they will let the market control it. They can't go back in and say, hey, well, we decided, you know, $4 isn't enough. We want it to be $8 next week because we didn't make enough money. That they can't do. But if the market drives it up to $8, then the market drives it up because it could drive it back down just as fast.
And that makes sense why it would be based to the pound, so that they could do that like that.
Absolutely.
So you're getting
so
your Bentley.
Don't let the 2% bother you. Because okay. Iraq is not going to be controlling the market from there anyway. You and I are going to be controlling the market, how fast we sell, how much we sell, the fund managers and everybody else, how much they buy into it, is how fast they push it up, and then how much they try and flip it. Just like I said earlier, you know, I try and flip money on IPOs, penny stocks, and I mean flip it. I mean, like, people go out and try and flip real estate. They buy it,
right, get
a contract for it, hold it, try and sell it to make a profit. It may take them 90 days to do that if they're flipping a property. You can flip a contract in 48 hours and make money in real estate, because I've done all of that. But
cool.
In currency, IPOs in penny stocks, you're talking about flipping. I'm buying it this morning, selling it this afternoon, and I made a whole lot of money in doing that. So this can go the very same way.
Okay, and the last part of my question would be, and I kind of have a feeling like we're going to have a little bit of a like the Bill Clinton era when they revalued Kuwait. Do you see that happening, or do you see it getting a little bit more serious for the U.S.?
You know, people are planning the other way because they just don't know until this actually goes through. I mean, this is being pushed so that that will happen, so that the U.S. will have a surplus.
Like the Bill Clinton.
You know, just like the Bill Clinton era. And, you know, I was saying today, regardless how the vote goes this year, whoever the next president is, he's going to have money to do whatever he decides to do because it is going to be like the Clinton era, and there is going to be a surplus of money. So, absolutely. But it's getting to that point. You know, just because we get it all today or tomorrow, it's going to take time to get out there, time to create the projects, the things, the jobs, but the money will be available. But in the meantime, the economy is still going to do what it does. Okay?
Okay. And hopefully we don't have anyone selling their dinar because that could drive the price down quickly too, right?
Well, everybody's going to be selling as soon as it hits 320.
Well, I mean selling before it happens.
Before it happens. No, because it's not on the Forex, so that's not going to change the price. They're just selling it back to the exchangers or the base. That's not on the Forex, so it doesn't help it go up or down. Now, as soon as it's on the board, it will absolutely affect the price of it. Absolutely.
Okay, cool. Well, I'm definitely going to be paying this forward, Tony, and I thank PTR for helping me to do that. And PTR rocks, man. I really appreciate it.
Okay. Well, thank you. And, Gary, you got all the information you need, right?
Yes,
yeah,
go
for Ned. Yep, you guys know me. Okay, thanks.
Okay,
thank you. Our next caller is coming out of, it looks like they're coming from Iowa, 563 area code, and they're on the line with us right now.
Is this me who's talking? You said Iowa?
Yeah, it is Iowa.
563.
No, it's...
No, that's right. It is Iowa.
Hold on. I just had to
two people? You got two?
Yeah, the system. We'll come to 608. The system, when I hit 4, it picked up two lines here. So
which one was first?
We're with Iowa, 563.
All right. Oh. This is Flacker 7 on the board. Can you guys hear me okay?
What did you say, Flacker 7?
Flagger.
Okay.
As in a the American flag.
Okay. All right. Good evening. How are you?
Hey, guys. Good. Right. Doing great. Good to visit with you today. First of all, let me add my kudos to the list. Just the way you guys have put this thing together, the website, the bull, I think, was a great idea. You've got some excellent, excellent mods, and seems like probably the most active board out there in the dinar world, it seems to me, and nice to be part of it. Really good to hear you guys. Look forward to your calls and enjoy getting those texts that kind of puts a special touch on it. You know something's going on when you get a text from PTR.
All right. Well, thank you. We appreciate it.
You bet. A couple of questions for you. You know, it seems like for the longest time there's been two schools of thought out there that this is driven a little bit more from inside Iraq and it still lies in their hands. And then the other school is it's basically left Shabibi and CBI's hands and is kind of more at the IMF and BIS level. You know, given the fact that now the troops have been pulled out and you've heard that word sovereign nation so many times since December, would you think that still would kind of connotate that this is this lies within Iraq's control yet, or do you guys really think that it's gone beyond that level and up to the IMF and BIS level?
You know, we heard that sovereign nation, and that always tells you that you're in control, you know, it's your country and everything else. And this is probably the only time that I can think of when that term has been misused, because we waited for that and wanted to say they were the decision makers. You know, we're hearing things last night, this week, and Gary can jump in if he wants to. We're under Article 142, and you guys can look it up under the IMF, just so you'll know. They still control Iraq's currency until it goes through an RIRB, until they're fully paid what they were loaned. And there's Iraq falls under the category of, you know, not emerging countries that are coming back that are controlled by the IMF. So while they gave them the autonomy to do what they wanted, when they wanted, say just that, hey, you're a sovereign nation, you did. There was a line in the sand drawn, and somebody crossed the information we have. And I'll tell you about that yesterday, what some of the agreements, I mean, the meetings, the agreements were about. Every part of this was reviewed. Gary, you want to say anything about any of this?
I think you're doing a good job here, and I'll just say we've heard that it has, you know, there is a point where the country still has responsibility and accountability for itself. There's also a point where once it's been released, it has moved into the control of the upper banking system. And at this point, we still believe that it is in the area. And when you say up in the BIS does not have any authority over the currency and, you know, giving it permission or denying it the ability to be approved or RV. What they do are is a service entity. They work and coordinate information between the central banks. They do have a board, and their function is working with the Basel board and Basel compliance. And the Basel board is the entity that basically is where everything is set up and downloaded into the banking systems going out to your, not to your central banks, but to your international banks. And then, of course, the international banks send it out to their branches. So when they're told, you know, it's to be released, it's sent out. And basically the decision-making is done between, from what we understand and are being told, is between the central bank or the CBI along with the IMF and the World Bank. They basically are the ones that everything works through and in between, and each of them have the authority. Once all three of those are in agreement, they basically notify the BIS to release it. And so at this point,
okay, but the person,
we were told that
people,
that was done.
Yeah, people who have the actual authority would be, one, the CBI,
that's right,
and ultimately the IMF. Those are the only two who have the authority to actually say, CBI can say we're doing it, and IMF can say we're doing it because you didn't. Is that right?
They can push it through, correct.
Okay.
Guys, who do you think's driving the rate then? Do you think the IMF is going to drive the rate, or is that going to kind of come mostly from Shabibi?
You know, you got some good questions. I like that. Okay. And I'm going to tell you guys this because you're going to see it anyway. This is a good way to know who made this happen, a very good way. And if you're really paying attention, you're going to get something out of this. If the IMF was doing it, it would come out in that $3 range. If Iraq is doing it, it's going to be substantially higher when it comes out. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Hope everybody got that. I just told you about the mouse and the cheese, so you'll know, depending on which one happens. Now, a different scenario is this, just so you guys understand it too. If the IMF did it and it came out at a $3-something rate, Iraq would still have the option to RV at a later date. And if I took a baseball bat and hit you over the head, I couldn't have told you any better than what I just said. Okay? All right.
Got it. Got it, Tony.
Okay.
I love that when you know you got to protect your sources, but when you're trying to tell us something and you tell us you're trying to tell us something without saying it, we know some heavy stuff hopefully is going down, right?
Let's hope so. God knows.
Hey, Gary, just wondering, have you had any interesting conversations with Dr. Todd in the last 24, 48 hours?
Well, that's where Tony and I are.
Now we're going to see who tells the truth. Who doesn't.
Yeah. The conversations have been positive, and he was the one that helped clarify where the trigger point was, number one, and the fact that there's now supposed to be movement. So we're expecting to see some good things.
So Dan had mentioned the other day, forget about any given day of the week. That's out the window now. Do you think that still applies?
Well, yeah, I think it still applies. You should forget about it. It could happen at any time, but more importantly, what he was really trying to say, and I think is really important, guys, you're so close now, that would be my furthest worry was when it would be, am I ready? You know, do I have a strategy either way? I mean, a thought-out strategy, not let me see what happens and then I'll do it. I got a strategy to go if it comes out at $3.50, $6, $8. I have my strategies. Not in my head, written out, explained. I know what I'm going to do because, you know, I mean, you could wake up in the morning and say, God, I really didn't believe it. I thought it was next Tuesday, Wednesday. I thought it was Thursday. And it could go that long, but it couldn't either. So what he's saying is, I mean, at this point, even the information we got today, in the last 3 hours, that wouldn't be my concern when or how much. It's, what am I going to do now?
Yep.
Okay.
Well, Tony, do us a favor. Make sure those hotels in San Francisco are well stocked with single malt. And when I see you out there, you can steer me to where I can get a really fine cigar, okay?
They have some good cigar bars in Frisco. So for those who smoke, I'm sure we'll probably buy them out. So while we're there, we'll restock. But we'll have a good time.
Yeah, it sounds good. Well, I look forward to sharing a scotch and a cigar with you guys. And again, thanks for all that you do. You do a great job, and keep up the great work. Sound like things are really positive, and we're looking for some good stuff to happen, hopefully real quick here.
All right, thanks. Thanks for being a member.
You bet. Thanks, guys.
All right. Bye.
Okay, our next caller, the one that was tied in, is coming from Wisconsin. It looks like 608 area code. Let me bring him on. There we go. You're online with us.
Hi, Gary and Tony. It's great to talk to you guys. I'm Arskow on the board, and have been looking at this for a number of years, went back to Dinar Vet days, and do I dare ask the question about the 99999? Tony, are you pretty positive we're going into the weekend? Do we actually think we have a deadline now, a drop-dead date?
I think we have a drop-dead date. I do. Well, simply because I was told we do. But in the sense of not really Iraq, but some other things that are supposed to be taking place in some other places, some other countries, which would make this hard to keep stringing out. So, and I think that has to happen. But just some things that are going on, some meetings that take place that me and Gary both know about, some decisions that were made yesterday, I think gives us a date and time. And I don't think we have to worry about this for weeks and months and days anymore. I think all that part is over with.
Okay? That'd be fantastic. Earlier in the week, you talked about pay attention to Christine Lagarde, and she's kind of faded away and hasn't really done anything a lot publicly other than a few days ago. Is that part of this? Is it all settled? The $1 trillion that they were trying to backstop for the IMF, is that settled at this point?
I was going to say the last thing she did was fade away. Believe me, we wouldn't even have this conversation right now if it wasn't for her. So believe me, she's doing her job. Okay. So, yeah, and if we do hear something about Greece, you're going to have to know where it came from. You're going to have to know everything that was being put together with the whole global restructure has occurred, because that's the only way they're going to get any money. That's the only way they're going to get saved. And not that the RV was everything for that, but it was a big part of making that happen. So you can't do one without the other. If you could, guess what? They would have already saved Greece. They'd have already saved the euro. All those meetings and things that they were having and money that was being pledged would have already been done if they weren't waiting for the RV. Because it's such
Are we still waiting for any public announcements?
We're not going to get any public announcement. We're going to get some people, friends that you know, calling you, telling you, guess what I just went to my bank and saw, or heard, or did, okay? Or guess what just happened? Somebody called somebody, and that's going to be your announcements.
Okay.
Oh, besides PTR, we're going to announce it.
On the board where they're talking about some live rates or switching from 0.000 to some other numbers for all these currencies on these major bank currency exchanges. Is that something that's happened here today?
Well, since you brought it up, I have a copy of a bank screen that was sent to me that showed all the zeros gone, all the countries have filled in rates. There is a, and this is not at the bank teller, it's at the actually, they're saying branch manager, currency department, and above on their screens, and there are different level screens that, yeah, all those have changed. The zero zeros have been there for a couple of weeks now. They've gone back in. And actually, it is showing a live rate. They are live rates. They just haven't been pushed for yet. And I don't know the time frame for that to happen, because I really don't. I wish I did. That's why I say we're closer than ever. And that was a couple hours ago. We got that. We got the live rates. I got a copy of the screen. And then those rates have even changed since 3 hours ago. So, and I'm trying to give you guys a little bit of information. So, and these are what they're pushing out from different banks. And I'm telling you, I've been on a phone call. It happened in New York. It happened in Texas. It happened in Tennessee. It happened mostly on the East Coast. And it's kind of like it's going through the system, because we got a call from Arizona. They're seeing something else. And even this is just a little tidbit of information for you guys. Like Bank of America, from the state of Washington down California, all that, they're on a different system from the rest of the country. And I'm telling you, I know it. If I sent a wire to from California to New York, and wires normally go through in a day, it's great. If you send one, I mean, it'll go out and they'll get it. If they send one from New York to California, even though you'll see it, they'll say you can't get it till the next day because we're on different systems. Or they make a cash deposit because they're on two totally different systems, which is really crazy. And that's Bank of America. The other banks, they have their set up in regions also. So it's kind of what we said we would see the RV happen from east to west. All the changes are coming from east to west. that's probably more information than you guys want, but okay.
So these folks might be more excited when you talk to them with this recent change?
Well, they're excited. I'm just waiting to get me excited.
Okay. I hear you.
Yeah,
I don't want to take I don't want to take too much more of your time. I just want to express how thankful I am for all the time you put in, Tony. Gary, you're fantastic. Dan is great. Sometimes he gets me down when he's too serious, but PTR is fantastic. I'm paying this forward, and I want to let somebody else get on.
All right, thank you. We appreciate it. Hey, you asked some really good questions, and I know a lot of people appreciate those questions. But, you know, we're a whole lot closer than we think, guys. All right,
hope to see you guys in San Francisco. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Well, Tony, we're getting slowed down here. We wanted to do 14 today if we can, but here we go. Our next caller is coming in from Florida, and the area code there is 850.
Well, Gary, you know, my first question to you is, you got a mouse in your pocket or something?
Not yet.
About we.
Oh, we. Okay.
Who are you talking about? We want to do 14.
Well, Dan and I want to get some more currency out there. We're spreading it around. Hey, what can I say? Pay it forward.
I was going to say, I think Dan was drinking something, but I don't know what, but go ahead.
Hi. Hello?
Hello there.
Hi, this is Arnett 21 from the board. Just want to say hello to everybody. Thank you guys so much for what you're doing. You guys have been such a great thing to listen to, and just all of your support here has been absolutely wonderful. I had a quick question. Well, it's not really that quick. I know that the dinar is supposed to be tied to the euro, and I'm just wondering, is there any way that we can switch it over to other forms of currency without switching to the dollar? Is that possible for people who live in the U.S.?
Oh, you want to trade your dinar for like the Great British Pound instead of the dollar?
No. Because I've been told like that we should also diversify our currency, so not just have money in the dollar, but also have it in maybe the Chinese yuan or maybe a Scandinavian coin. So I'm just wondering.
You want to exchange it for one of those currencies?
Yes.
Okay. I think the dinar banker, dinar trade, were actually going to try and do that, and they found out they were not able to do that. They wanted to be all cashed in here first, and then you buy that second currency. And the reason being, if you just trade the currency for currency, you're not paying any taxes on that. So they want you to get the dollars, pay your taxes, do what's right, and then go out and buy some more currency if you want to.
Okay. Thank you.
That was your only question?
That was the only question. I mean, you guys pretty much answered all of my needs, so thank you very much.
Well, I don't care what Dan said. If you guys don't ask a whole lot of questions, that means we got to give away a whole lot of money. So I prefer you ask a whole lot of questions. No, thank you. Thank you for being on. All right.
All right, thank you.
All right. Okay.
Looks like our next caller is from, in fact, Florida also, 407. Is that Florida, Tony?
Hello.
We'll find out. Hello.
Hello.
Hi, this is Florida Lady. Yes, we are from Florida. How are you?
Okay. Good. How are you?
Doing good. Excited about being on the call with you guys. We've cried numerous times, so this is very exciting. Thanks for taking our name here. Just want to first of all say thank you to all you guys. Y'all are just wonderful, all the information you bring and your patience, and you will be greatly rewarded for all the paying forward that you're doing, and we do appreciate it.
Oh, I thought you were going to say for all the pain we're suffering doing this, but okay. But.
I hope you're not suffering too much pain. I hope it's just paying it forward.
Yes. And I'm having a good time doing it. I don't know about anybody else, but I'm having a good time. But go ahead.
I know it comes across in your voice that you enjoy it. That's great.
Yeah.
Just have one quick question, because some of the other questions we had have already been answered. But we were wondering if in the future you're also going to be sharing some information with us about additional currencies in the future.
You know, I hope to, if we're able to, but, you know, there's some other countries coming up, and I had already checked with some of our sources, and they're checking to see if they're even going to be able to get the currency the way we did this. I mean, some things are going to have to happen first. We're able to do this because of a presidential order that allowed us every right that an Iraqi citizen has in getting that. We're just not sure the process is going to be for the other countries yet.
Okay. Well, we appreciate letting us know whatever you find out. We're trying to do some research on it, too. But also the IPOs that are coming up, you had talked about them earlier a little bit. So we're looking forward to hearing everything you have about those also.
Yeah. Well, we're going to try and, you know, give everything we got. Like I said, I put out a request this morning for some people. If they've done IPOs, know about some. I'm not going to recommend any IPOs to anybody because, you know, you have to do your own research and do that. I mean, I'll recommend Facebook and Twitter and that. You know they're not mine. I don't have anything to do with the company. And I think you're practically guaranteed to make that kind of money or make some money out of those. A lot of IPOs, just so you guys know, if I was you, I'd be doing my research right now. I mean, you have to kind of pick the right companies, larger companies, and be able to get, you know, something out of it. So while it is very, very lucrative, it's very risky at the same time. That's why I say no guts, no glory. So, but we'll let you know.
Okay. I guess the very last question I have then real quickly is if you've heard anything else on the dong.
I did, and I heard it's going to be an unbelievable price, and I'm not going to quote it for you right now, though, but I heard it's going to be an unbelievable price.
Okay, well, we appreciate it, and once again, thank you guys for everything. We thoroughly enjoy being a part of PTR, and hopefully someday get to meet all you guys.
Okay, you too. All right.
Thank you.
We got another caller coming in from Florida, same area code. Maybe they're neighbors here. 407, you're on with us.
Thank you. This is Dinar Mark on the boards. It looks like there's a lot of Floridians today. How are you guys doing?
Doing good. How you guys doing?
We're doing good. It's raining over here, though. Listen, most of my questions have been answered, but there are a couple of things I still want to kind of throw in there. I know you were mentioning or talking with someone earlier about the IMF having control, because I've been hearing a lot on the board that they might have the ability to be able to push an RV themselves. Is that true?
That is true, and you guys can go look it up for yourself. It's Article 142 under the IMF. It tells you how they can control in other countries' money, what agreements were made, and everything else. So it is, it actually is out there. Or I was getting ready to throw somebody under the bus, but they might get mad at me. And say, you all could ping this one person, they can tell you. But that's okay. Yes, the information is out there. Absolutely.
Is that what's kind of putting a lot of the pressure on them right now, you think?
I absolutely believe it is. I mean, we've heard the threat for months now, but at some time you got to back the threat up and say enough is enough. And what's going on, again, you guys mentioned it, Greece, the euro, all those things that are about to take place, the downgrades. If you've been looking, watching the news, looking at the articles, you'll see they said that a whole Western Hemisphere was about to be downgraded, and nobody wants to go through what that would do. So they're kind of pushing it through, I think. Well, I'm going to say this. They're either going to push it through or Iraq has made the decision that it's time to do it. And you guys will be able to figure it out by the numbers. I won't have to tell you.
Yeah, because don't they have the WTO or something like that coming up here in March?
They do, and they've even put articles out on what they need to do to be part of it, what they expect of them, the economy and everything else. So, yes.
And I haven't heard too much of Maliki
lately in the news. Is the government and the herbal and the HCL and all that in place ready to go once it's all? Because I guess it's not sounding like it, in my personal opinion, it doesn't sound like it's in Iraq's hand really at all anymore, based on the fact that you don't hear much about Shabibi or Maliki or any of the, you know, parliaments arguing over government officials or any of that stuff. Is that all that ready to go?
Gary, you want to answer that?
You're doing pretty
I'm trying
good,
to get Gary to speak up here, but look.
Hey,
everything
I know. This way I can't slip, Tony.
Oh, look. Everything I've heard, it is, in fact, ready to go. It just hasn't gone. Now, is Chief up here? He might want to argue with me. Chief trying to take Dan's spot when he's not here. You know, they kind of go against what I say. Anyway, Chief, you up here? No.
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay.
I'm like rolling over my leg right now.
But you got some articles about the about what's going on, the HCL, herbal agreement, the ministers. I mean, what's your opinion there? Is it done? Is it not done?
Personally, I think it's all done. I think the banks are done, too. If you look at the IMF documents, the World Bank documents, everything was slated to be completed by December 31st. You look at Scooter's research, everything that he's put out, the banking industry over there, or the banks over there, are supposed to have the best technology in the world. You've got a currency that has five security features on it, one of the most advanced in the world. Why not have a banking system the same way? I mean, I think everything is done. I think all this crap that we've been seeing is just that, crap. And whatever, you know, BIS is trying to line up with the IMF and the World Bank to make this thing happen, I think we're at that pinnacle. The EU is getting ready to collapse, and they're at a peak right now, so something has to give. I've been saying that for the last 3 or 4 days now, and hopefully we're there.
And that's what I feel,
well,
I feel like everything.
Wait a minute. Because I did not expect that from him. He messed up my whole thing. Let me talk to Viper. I need a Dan on the phone. Wait, look, no. All right, go ahead. What was yours? Good.
Well, you don't hear Maliki. You don't hear much going on about the. Lately, all it's been about is U.S. Treasury and everybody, the IMF. It hasn't really. I haven't really heard much about Iraq itself. And I guess my question is, if the IMF is starting to put pressure on Iraq, then I guess it does bring it back to Iraq, and it is in their hands. And if they're putting pressure on them, what is the pressure? Because if everything's ready, part of me feels like it is in Iraq's hand, but the other part of me feels like it's not in their hand. So therefore, how can IMF put the pressure on them if it really, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, then, well, wait a minute. Let me first say, Chief, do you want to answer that?
No, you go ahead.
Okay. All right. First of all, the IMF says the buck stops here. Mm-hmm. But before the buck gets here, do what you're supposed to do. Okay? It's just like any of your children, right? I'm telling you, take the trash out. Take the trash out. It's the last time I'm telling you, take the trash out. And if I have to take it out, you're not going to like it. Right? Because that's how we said to our kids. Then that's where it's Iraq. Okay? I'm giving you every opportunity to do this, stand up, and say I did this. Because if you don't, I'm going to do it, and I'm not going to do it at the rate you wanted me to do it at. I'm going to make you suffer. What does that mean? I'm not going to do it as high as you wanted it. I'm going to make you start from the bottom because I had to do it. So that's why it's in their hands, but it's out of their hands. So I'm saying the IMF has released it saying, okay, there it is. Now, what are you going to do? Don't make me do it, but, you know, we'll see.
And is Shabibi the one? Because, again, now we bring Shabibi in the picture, and inflation has got to be over 10% right now. So isn't this kind of putting pressure on him too? Or what happened with him? I mean, he's kind of disappeared into the background a little bit. I haven't really heard too much about him either.
Well,
especially with the inflation.
I'm pretty sure it has put pressure on him, but, you know, we say Shabibi can do it when he wants to. I know there's some things that need to happen, but he still has to live there too, so let's not forget.
Yeah.
It's not like living here, okay, when you make a decision.
Well, listen, you guys answered my question. Y'all doing a great job. That pretty much sums it up for me.
Okay, well, thank you.
I appreciate the opportunity.
All right. Also, Gary, that's about, what, 13 of them? No.
Hey, we're not even close. Not close yet here. Halfway. All right, our next one's coming from a, looks like, again, 352. That's down there in Florida. So we've got him on the line with us.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can. How are you?
We are.
I'm fine. Thank you for asking. I feel so honored to be on the call this evening. I've tried so many times, and I couldn't believe I got that email. Thank you so much, guys.
You're welcome. And persistence pays off. So
it sure does. It sure does. Well, a lot of what I wanted to talk about and ask seemed to have been, while waiting, I've heard so many of these questions. So I kind of just have a few things I wanted to maybe ask that maybe you could just give me a little bit of insight on this. One of them is, how can one country hold up the whole world in a global reset? If this is true, I keep hearing about a global reset, restructuring, so many different words. And I know that most of us are holders of IQD and possibly VND and so on. And maybe a couple other people have been pretty creative in whatever they do. But how can one country really do this? And I just don't get it.
Well, they can up to a point, and that's what we're saying, until, hey, now you're dragging everybody down. We're letting you do it. You got to remember something. This whole plan was built around that country. When this whole thing started, again, with the first Bush, even though I know you guys don't know that, but it did, it was just about Iraq and the U.S. and Europe. Those were the only three countries were involved in this. It was about changing our economy. It was about, what some of you do know, going back to the Clinton era where we had no debt, and they figured that's how it happened because of what happened in Kuwait. Well, if it could happen with a little Kuwait, and it wiped out our debt, what could happen with a big Iraq? What could we do? And that's really where this whole thing came from. Now, as the process is taking longer than expected, because it was supposed to be a 3-year process, not a 10-year process, but they went over there, and I'm going to tell you guys, before we ever went to Iraq, I know I've said it myself, and probably a thousand of you guys said the same thing. We're never going to win, and I mean that, because it's going to be like Vietnam, because we don't know which one is our enemy and which one wasn't. And we went over there, and that's exactly what we found, and it took longer than expected. So I'm saying win is like, you know, if we go to war with somebody, a country against country, and we just win. Over there, a whole lot of things had to be sorted out, and they're still being sorted out today. Who's on our side? Who isn't on our side? You know, which one's right, which one's wrong. So that took longer than expected. Now, during the process, the global economy continued to deteriorate, and some other people wanted a piece of that pie because they saw what was going on and said, wait a minute, we want to be included on that. Wait, we want to get part of that because we see what you're doing. We didn't see it the first time with Kuwait because they didn't. But this time it's obvious to a whole lot of people. So while they weren't part of the original plan, and Iraq was, that piece still has to fit in order to make everything else work. So that's why they're holding us up. But even now, their hand is being forced, or the time is coming near, however you want to do it, to say, hey, you know, we went as long as we can go. We can't do it anymore. Let's make this happen.
Okay. Well, thanks for that bit of info. I mean, I have not been around for long enough to, but I'm just so very curious about a few other things. Like, I noticed, for example, I'm hearing that this is supposed to be top secret. Nobody's supposed to know when it's going to happen, the date, nor the rate, nor anything for that matter. And I've been thinking for a long time, when we hear a particular date being thrown out there, whether it's on a call or on the boards or wherever we see it, Do you think this has had anything to do with them? If this person got this close, they were like, this person has called it for this time, so we have to go back and make changes. Do you think this is happening, or am I thinking too much?
I don't think anything, well, I'm not going to say anything. Some things we have said on the board have mattered, and it has caused them to make some changes. Even with how we cash in, how we move the money, all that stuff wasn't in place, and we've actually been told they've gotten it off the boards. We've made them think about things that they didn't even think about because we weren't involved in it before. So, I mean, even the banking procedures, the tax procedures, the cash out procedures, I mean, they weren't worried about that when it started because it was going to be like Kuwait. You know, some government guys were going to know about it and the rich were going to get richer and a few of us little stragglers were, you know, were going to happily get paid out of it. But it's grown, it's so many people involved, and it's going to affect the economy. Yes, some changes had to be made. At the same time, people have been throwing out dates and rates because that's the information they've been given, information I've been given. But we didn't know at the same time that there was one more piece to the puzzle. And then there was one more piece that had to go. Even guys who've got the information, hey, that's it. We're already ready to go, and we should see it at this date and time. You know, which where the right hand didn't talk to the left hand because they're all government agencies and said, oh, no. Prime example, I'm going to give you guys again. We had no clue up until last week that the IQD, and I went and looked at it. If you guys go over to the Chicago Mercantile Exchange and look in the futures market, how many currencies are listed right there in the futures market? Well, this had to be set up over there, and it didn't happen, I'm telling you, until last week. I mean, it's for months and months and months. We never even knew that needed to happen, but it's another piece that had to happen before it went. So a lot of people throughout the years, because it's been years, have thought that has got to be the final piece and we're ready to go, and people in that department thought so. I mean, the banks thought, yep, this is it, or security, or the CIA, or you know, FBI, or the Treasury, and they didn't look at what somebody else was doing, their piece of the plan had to be moved in too. So I don't think there is any one person who knew every single thing that had to be completed. There's probably five or six of them, but not any one. But other than them, everybody's always thinking this is the final piece. Even today, right now, with what we're seeing, what we're being told on the boards, I mean, documents that I got, copies of that saying, this has got to be it. I mean, not only that, but I know they've gone back to extra currency. I mean, new contracts for security, a whole lot of things has happened in the last 48 hours. And they're saying, be ready, be ready, be ready. And, okay, then I'm ready, you know. But something could still happen. I don't know. I'm hoping not.
Okay. I don't know if I'm running out of time, so let me quickly ask you. I've heard where it said bank screens are zeros and countries were losing lots of money because with that happening, I figure people wouldn't be able to change and do exchanging of currencies. But when you go into a local bank and you're still able to change currency, doesn't that really put a damper on what is being said that doesn't seem like it could be right at all?
Now, that's a really good question. Why are the bank screens zeroed out, but you can still go into a bank and exchange currency, or you can still go to the airport and exchange currency and everything else? That's
yes.
Your question, right?
Yes, that's
because
pretty much what I'm saying.
Those are not the exchanges that are being restricted. At that point in time, it's interbank exchanges that are being restricted. It's interbank forexes that are being restricted because they think this is about to happen. And nobody wants to get caught in the middle of a trade when it does happen. That's why they're zeros. It's their business. It's like exchanges take place on different levels. Okay, we as the public are going to do it. National banks here are going to do it. International banks are going to do it. And countries are going to do it. Like we have two traders for our country. I think, is it two, Gary? New York? Anyway, two guys who actually trade for our country. Their trades are totally separate from Forex trades and for bank trades and from our trades. So it's on a different level, and that's what we try and get people to. Just because you're hearing something, even right now, if I showed you guys the screenshots that I got looked at them, and you go to the bank, it's not going to be the same because that's at the currency department. The bank is going to, the currency department is telling the bank, yeah, go ahead and trade because we're going to close out like we normally do because we have set a rate at that level. But at the higher levels, it's totally different because they're not going to get caught in the middle of a trade of that magnitude. Everybody understand that? Did that even make sense to you guys?
Yes, okay. It does make a lot of sense. Well, I am not going to keep, you know, because I know you have a lot of other people who need to talk to you. But earlier, a caller said something, asked about, and you quoted an article, because I've been wondering if banks are really truly that powerful when it comes to holding on and freezing your money and all that. And you, I think you mentioned something about an article somewhere. Could you repeat that article?
Article 142, the IMF. What gives them the authority over countries and their currency?
Okay. All right. So I'm going to
look it up.
You
can just Google it right now, and you can look it up.
Okay. I definitely will do that because I'd like to get, you know, my thinking in all of this, and by the way, I did forget to tell you that I'm GB63 on the board, and I didn't say that when I started. But I am feeling like what it is happening is that we have gotten a lot of time. You know, we have all been waiting, you know, you, me, all of us, we've been waiting for the grand moment. And I'm just thinking that still a lot of us, we are really so concerned about when it's going to happen and what's the date and what's the rate that we haven't even gotten around to what are we going to do when it does happen. And I have always felt like if you fail to plan, you plan to fail. And so it's my thinking that while we're here waiting and, you know, people are getting frustrated and some are even getting rid of their IQD and all that. You know, it's that we need to really develop a don't quit mentality and go for this ride and know that when we started this, there was no, it's today, it's tomorrow. It, you know, it will happen. And when it happens, it's going to be the right time. So rather than us, when it happens, running around like a chicken with the head cut off, we need to really get our house in order and not really worry so much. And I'm glad that you guys have educated us the way you are. If you guys could maybe put together, like, you know, little what to do. Not that you're being a lawyer or giving legal advice, but a lot of us out here, we have no clue. You tell some people about the LLC, they're like, what? What is that? You know, there's a lot of people who got involved in this because a friend told them about it. You know what? They have no clue what it is they've gotten themselves into. And they bought the money, and they have it. And when it's time to change it, there's going to be so many people who will be worse off than they were a year from now, if that long, because they really, truly are not educated. And what if there was some way you could put it out there, folks, get educated on what it is that you've gotten involved with and make a plan so that you're not a failure going forward. So that's just my little bit. Well, it kind of looked like it was a lot. But I just want to say thanks for having me and thanks for the unique website, The Bull. It's just unique. It's awesome. And I say PTR rocks.
Okay. Well, thank you. And you said a mouthful. Believe me. And we've been trying to do that for months and weeks and days, trying to tell people to have a plan. I can't reiterate that any more than you just did. Except I will tell you this, and I hate to say it, and I know we've said it before. You know, lottery winners out there, and some people, you're going to absolutely hate this money when you get it. I mean, you're going to hate it for three. Yes?
Sorry to interrupt there, but there's a question on board right now. You said Article 142, and there's a member that's saying that to tell you that it's Article 1-4 of the IMF.
1-4, yep, he's right.
Okay. So it's not 1-4-2 then.
Yeah, he is right. I actually have it right here.
So it's Article 1-4.
4, yep.
Okay,
Okay, but let me finish this. There's three things.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. But there's three things I'm telling you guys, and this is what I want and hope that you can avoid. But if you don't, do what she just said, do what we've been trying to tell you, because it's what happens. You get the money, and you're scared to death because you have it, don't know what to do with it, and you're scared you're going to lose it, which you could. Your family and friends are going to change. They're going to change. They're going to say it's you, but it's probably going to be them and the way they look at you. So those are two things that are going to really, really bother you. And then if you don't know what to do with it, protect it, how to pay your taxes, you're going to spend it all. The IRS is going to come after you, and you're going to owe them the rest of your life because you're going to have no way at all to repay the taxes, interest, and everything else that you're going to get hit with this if you don't take care of it first. So those are the three things that I want you to know. If you don't do it right, that's what you're going to face. It may be a year from now, 2 years from now, 3 years, but that's where you'll end up if you don't do it right. I'm just telling you. And you'll hate you ever, ever were a millionaire, 100,000 there, and you'll be saying, I wish I never even got that money, because you're going to spend it frivolously anyway. It's going to be gone, and the debt's going to hang on you forever if you don't do it right. So anyway, thanks again. All right, Gary.
Okay, our next caller, it looks like from the Carolinas there, 803. You're on.
Hi. This is Dan O'Bear on the screen.
Okay, how you doing?
Pretty good. I live in North Carolina, too.
Where?
Out in the Asheville area.
Asheville?
Yeah, the mountains.
Oh, okay. Okay.
First of all, I'd like to say thank you very much, you, Dan, and Gary. And not only that, the mod people on the board, Butch and Country Girl and everybody, they're grip. They're all great.
Okay.
They all do a great job. Now, my question, and, you know, you're saying plan, but it's hard to plan if you don't know how much it's going to be. And considering that a lot of us haven't put a lot of money into the, you know, into the Iraqi dinars, so what we get back, there was a lot that it was going to be one-to-one. And you seem to, you're saying, well, it could be an RI, which would be $3 and something. That makes a big difference. I mean, if you have a million
let me ease your mind right now, okay?
Okay.
I'm going to tell you the plan right now. Plan on it being $3. Plan on that.
Okay.
And everything above that is just going to be extra. But make your plan based on $3, and you're going to be okay.
I really appreciate it. And then the other side of that is, and this has been all over the place too, some people say they're not going to tax it, which I think is absolutely ridiculous. Some say it'll be taxed at 15%. I listened to the trust thing, and that guy was saying 35 or more percent of that will be taxed. And
okay.
I was just wondering you and Gary's input in terms of what you think.
Well, I'm going to tell you what I think right now. Plan on 35%. Why? Because if it's less than 15%, the rest is just gravy. But plan on the worst, hope for the best. But plan on the worst. I think $3 is the worst. I think 35% is the worst. Even though I think it's going to be 15%. But anyway, 35% okay. is the worst. So plan on that. And then everything else is extra. I mean, make it easy on yourself. Okay, but Gary, you have an opinion?
No, I'm agreeing with you 100%. The problem is some people are looking at 10. I've heard people looking at 15. I've heard people saying, I don't have to pay taxes at all. Bottom line, plan to pay the maximum, and then everything else is a surprise. You won't be disappointed.
And I think that no matter who you are, getting advice from professional CPAs and attorneys is a good idea.
Oh, definitely.
Oh, absolutely, because that's where it's going to end up. But if you're doing your own plan before you talk to them, even after, just plan on the worst-case scenario.
And I have one more request. I'm going to be in San Francisco. I'm a songwriter, and I have a song I'd love to play for you guys. It's called Everyday Heroes, and I think you guys are.
Oh, man, that's too much. No, see? If you would have just surprised us with it, okay. But now, that's too much. We're nobody's hero. We're just some guys trying to make it through this, and we're everyday guys just like everybody else, and we're just in a position and have been in some great positions to make a little bit of money. We're trying to share it, and hopefully, you know.
Come on, you don't wear a cape. Come on.
I don't. No S on my chest, nothing else. Or carries anybody else. We just, you know, a guy told my wife this one time, and he was trying to get us to go to church and do something. She said, no, no, no. And he said, well, wait a minute. You're messing up my blessing by not accepting what I'm trying to give you. You know, and he said, this is my blessing. I'm being blessed that I'm able to do this. By you not taking it is messing up my blessing. So, okay, so we took it. So, I mean, I look at this. We are very blessed, believe me. Me, Dan, and Gary, even though we have things in our own lives, but to be able to be right here at this part right now, even understanding this. So, and we're just paying it forward right now, and we're going to continue afterwards. Well, at least Dan is, because he's going to be here for a year. You guys heard him say that, right, Gary? No.
Definitely.
I can say whatever I want about Dan right now. But anyway, thank you.
Education, and you guys are the source in terms of educating people on what to do. And I'm going to get off, but when I get the dinars, I'm going to send you guys some copies of my CD.
You can do that. And if, I mean, you want to sing in Frisco? Hopefully we'll have a venue to do that. But do it for everybody there. Do it for the audience, because they're going to be heroes for a whole lot of people in the future.
Oh, I'm sure.
All right. Okay.
Thank you very much.
All right. Thanks. Bye-bye.
Our next caller is coming from a big state out there, and Texas. Here we go. They're on.
Hello.
Yep, she's from Texas.
No, No. I bet if I talk just a little while longer, you'll know where I'm from. Well, I really didn't have a question, but my son did. He says
he knows
that you get a lot of misinformation, but he wants to know how can you tell what's true and what isn't.
You know, what I try and do is, you know, I talk to Gary in the morning. I say, hey, what did you hear? This is what I've heard. And,
so
you know,
you
and I talk
to her the truth. You got to tell her the truth. We line this stuff up on a piece of paper, and we get a coin. Heads is true, tails is false. He swept, I swept. And that's how we figured out. Right, Tony?
It would probably work out the same way if we did that.
So it's anybody's guess.
Yeah. But what we try to do is really, just see how many sources are seeing the same thing. See, when I can get the same thing from different people, then I can go with that. And then, but if it's different and I say, you know, I'm waiting to see, do I hear this? You know, we get stuff out of Washington, then we'll get stuff out of the banking sector. And then we'll get something out of, people in the Forex. And then we get something out of Iraq, out of three different sections over there. And let's see how much of it is the same, then we can go with it. And then if it's just too outlandish, like somebody comes on, oh, no, I just heard this morning it's going to be another 60 days. And we say, are you crazy?
Yeah.
I mean, everything is going on right now, and you think it's going to be another 60 days. Then we can just blow that away. Or somebody comes on and says, nope, I just heard $14. It's coming out at $14, going up to $18.
Oh, wow.
Then I have to say, then I don't know what you're smoking, but keep it to yourself, you know, or whatever, you know. Just, I mean, there's some just outrageous things that we get that we just know aren't true. Uh-huh. And then there are some people who come back and, I mean, some of our sources have actually come back and said, you know what, I know what I told you, and I'm sorry, but they told me to say this, told me to say that. They do watch your board. One guy actually told us, he said, man, you do not know. So-and-so said this on another board, and they are laughing so hard. I mean, they're just laughing at him. And I was like, man, that is not funny. And they're like, and they said it to him. I said, that's not funny.
No.
But they, you know, some of them think it is.
Right.
Because they know it's there. But we just have to, and it's part of our process. You know, we work through it all day, see what we can come up with.
Well, Tony, we really thank you for everything that you do. And I'd like to say hello to my three sons, Brandon, Terry, and Jason. And tell my husband who's on the road that I love him.
Okay.
That's all I got.
Do your three sons have Dinar?
Yes.
They do?
Yes, we
then,
do.
Just based on the fact that you said hello to them and you made them famous here on PTR today, I think they should at least donate half of their Dinar to their mom.
There you
so,
go. I'll
okay.
be sure to
there
tell them. They're going to listen to this call.
Okay. All right. Thanks for being on.
Thank you,
Tony. I got another one for you.
Okay.
Okay, bye-bye.
I'm sorry, didn't mean to interrupt you. From off the board, Tuck Finn's father's got a question. They gifted his niece $25,000 for Christmas and told her to file the 8938 form with the IRS. She called today and said that she was trying to file that form online, and it kept defaulting. It wouldn't let her file it. And they wanted me to ask if it's still required to do so.
You know, I'm going to go with, did you say Huck Finn?
Tuck Finn's father.
Tuck Finn's father, not Huck Finn. Okay. I'm going to go with, hey, if she tried it and they wouldn't accept it, I would keep a copy of that. I'm just going, if she has the form, then she also has the instructions, which tells her who's supposed to fill out that form, right?
Yes.
I hope so. Then that's all we can do. Whether they accept it on the 15th or the 12th or whenever they start accepting it or not, but it clearly states right there who's supposed to file it and for what reasons. And as long as she can show she attempted to file it, then I think she's okay. And if they say you didn't need it, you didn't need it. But I know what I've been told and some other people have been told. So you tried it. As long as you did that, I would think there's nothing they could do about it. As long as you can show you did try it.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Hey, we're down to the last three here. So take a deep breath. Here we go. This one is coming in from a 925 area code, and they're on the line with us.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. How you doing?
Good. This is Apron Lady's husband.
Okay. So are we supposed to call you Apron Lady or what?
No, Apron Man.
And there you go.
Okay.
I used to have one quick question for you guys. On all these cable channels, the business channels, Fox and CNN and Bloomberg, do those reporters know about this and just have it covered up, or what's the situation there?
You know, we have some clips that were on the internet where a guy was putting out information and saying, hey, they wanted me to put this out to you guys. This is the first case of making this information public. And we see it coming out in bits and pieces. Now, I was told over a year ago, that the media and the news and everybody were in fact informed and told not to report on this, not to put it out, because of just imagine what it would have done to our economy if it was out and on mainstream news every day about what's going to happen and when it's supposed to happen and who's involved in it. Then for the last year, everybody would have been buying Dinar, right?
Right.
Everybody has been trying to purchase it. Everybody would have, it's kind of like the banks telling all their people that it's going to happen. Then everybody would have just quit work. What I got to work for? My dinars get ready to revalue. Because they would have heard it every week just like we heard it. And everybody be sitting around waiting for it. So you're not going to broadcast something like that and actually kill the economy you're trying to build. Just like the banks aren't trying to kill a business that they're trying to build and make money by letting all their employees know before it happens. So No, I don't see that ever happening.
So
until
then,
after
then,
the fact.
Then most of those reporters probably are invested also in this.
I've seen some clips where reporters have said that. Yes, I got some. I have some, absolutely. Because you know what? I mean, just on happen chance, you think it's the craziest thing in the world. It could never happen. But what if it does? And I didn't spend $100. I'm going to be miserable forever. Or I didn't spend $1,000, which, you know, $100 isn't anything to some people, where $1,000 isn't to others. I would have invested it. I would have lost it at the casino or something anyway. So let's just take a chance. And some of them just do that because, you know, we already know that Dinar Banker and Dinar Trade, they'll buy it back from you for $800 anyway. So you gamble $200. So, yeah, I absolutely know they are. But same token, I got talking to a guy in Washington last week that, hey, there's a whole bunch of congressmen who don't even have Dinar, who don't even really know about the Dinar situation because they weren't part of it. They weren't part of the group putting it together. They're overworking their own special interest deals, making their own insider trades on their deals. So that's the difference.
Well, I want to thank you guys. I've been with you since People's Dinar days, and you guys are the best, and you put one hell of a lot of work in this for us. And it's really appreciated. See you in San Francisco.
All right. Thank you. We'll see you there.
Thanks.
Okay, our next caller is from, it looks like Virginia, and they're on the air with us. 540.
Hi, Gary. This is Silhouette on the board. Hi, Tony.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing great. I've sort of gotten past now that I know that it's going to happen any time now. I've gotten past that, and I'm really looking forward to some of these conference calls that you're putting together as far as the IPOs and, of course, Dan's real estate calls. Now, my IPR questions, IDQ questions, have pretty much been answered. So I'm just going to throw something out there, which you can comment on or not. I listened to Ben Bernanke, and it sounds like the Federal Reserve has no plans to leave. Is there going to be a global restructuring of banking from what you're hearing?
A global restructuring of banking?
Of finances, yes.
Well, let me see.
Let me touch on
that. Are you really do what?
Let me touch on that.
Okay.
I read an article early last year, probably March or April, that talked about our banking system here in the United States and how we are overwhelmed with banks in the U.S.
Okay.
I think it was about 23,000 banks that they had mentioned in the U.S., and they want to streamline that down to about 8,000 or 9,000 banks. 92 of them shut down last year. So we'll probably see some more shutdown this year, and it'll probably be a continual process until they get it streamlined down to where they want it, and that way they have a finer control of our finances. Because if you look at it, everything that we do is falling more and more under some form of control. You look at these new phones. You take a picture, and that phone has a GPS coordinate imprinted into that picture. So when you post that picture on the internet or somewhere, everybody knows exactly where you were when you took that picture. They can track you as long as that phone is on. And you think about it, the same thing is happening in finance. You know, money has security features on it. It won't be long before they start implanting RFID chips in money. There's so much stuff going on out there that we don't even have a clue as to what's happening. And the only way you can find out is to keep digging and keep digging and keep digging. But again, breaking those banks down into 8,000 or 9,000 banks nationwide, that's going to put a lot of companies out of business, a lot of banks out of business. And those that are strong, you're looking at a few of them already right now that are involved in this investment. So, yeah, I think you are going to see some changes. There are rumors of different currency. I'm not even going to say rumors. Glenn Beck brought it out talking about the Amero. And there's also been articles out about a Bancor note, which will replace the United States currency. There's so much stuff going on out there that we are not fully aware of. So you've got to keep an eye on things and actually do some research on it, because if you don't, even making a ton of money on this investment, you could hurt yourself in the long run if you don't put it in the right places.
Okay.
All right. I hope that answered your question.
Well, it just makes banks bigger. That's the only thing.
Exactly.
And like I said, and listening to Ben Bernanke, it doesn't sound like the Federal Reserve is going anywhere.
Well, they're going to be absorbed into the U.S. Treasury. That's basically what's happening.
That'll work fine. Okay. Well, listen, it was great getting on the call tonight. I'm going to pay it forward, the Dinar that I receive, and I really appreciate you sending me this email. I'll give you the extra few minutes for the next caller you need to talk to.
Okay, well, thank you. We appreciate it. Appreciate you being a member.
Oh, I love this board and all the people on it, and you and Dan and Gary and Dan are all special. So thank you. Good night.
All right, good night. Thank you.
Uh-huh.
Bye.
We're down to our last caller, and the last is always best usually, so here we go. They're calling in from, it looks like, Florida. And you're connected.
Hey, Tony.
Hey, how are you?
I'm doing great. I'm from Florida. I do appreciate the opportunity to be on this call. And everybody's already asked the question I was going to ask you, but I want to know what you feel about the Talabani. I read that he is going to resign because of his illness. Is that true?
From what I'm hearing, it's true. From my other sources, that's what we're hearing.
What
that he is because. Well, I don't know who his replacement is going to be. I know the procedure of even putting him in there, you know, and I hate to go back to that process. Believe me, that's why I wanted the RV to happen before.
Amen.
He resigned, and they argue about who, what, when, where again, and everybody wants their guy in here, their party. So I think Iraq is always going to have some problems, like I said before. So we're going to constantly see that. But I don't think we'll really care, guys. I don't think it's supposed to happen until mid-February. And at that point, you guys will probably never look at Iraq news again anyway.
Well, that's true.
Okay.
Well, listen, I want you to know that I just appreciate you guys. You do a great job, and it's a privilege to be a member of this board. And by the way, I'm Nanny Lane 1 on the board.
Okay. Well, thank you.
Okay.
And congratulations.
Well, thank you so much. I look forward to seeing you in San Francisco.
Okay.
I'm going to bring my non-believer husband with me.
Your non-believer, he'll be a believer by that time, huh? He'll be saying, you know what he's going to say? Well, you know, I had to keep her grounded. You know, that's all. I didn't want her to know. So anyway.
Okay. Well, listen, I appreciate it.
Okay, you too. Thanks again.
Bye-bye.
All right.
Hey, Tony.
Oh,
you made it.
Yes, sir.
That's all
you made it.
You're done.
Man, I can't believe it. Man. So how much did that cost us? Well, Gary, you got some comments? Any Miles want to say anything before we end this?
I think you've covered all the bases. And it's a Friday night, and I just want everybody to be able to go out there and enjoy their families and have a great weekend and look forward to watching what happens at the beginning of next week.
Okay.
Gary, did you see that article last year about the banks? I think I actually saw it on it was either CNN, Fox. They actually talked about it on the news.
Yep. And
I'm
there
sure
was one. There was also one. It's tied in with, I think it was February on Fox. talking about the adjustments and things. So it was, they've been talking about it for a while.
Yeah, I know. Okay, just wanted to make sure you were aware of it too. Figured you were.
Oh, much so. Okay, well, that's it for this Friday evening. Everybody enjoy themselves and have a great weekend. And we're going to also just hope that Dan has a good time while he's visiting with his family. So good night and enjoy your weekend.
All right, good night, everybody. Enjoy your weekend, and we're closer than close. So we'll talk to you later.
Night, everybody.
All right. All right, guys, yes, absolutely keep tweeting. Stay TNT strong. Stay together. Stay in the chat room.
Might as well kick you out of there. They've had a rough couple of days, guys. You need to take it easy on the mods, please, because they're not playing tonight. You guys will be gone. Right, all right. We need you.